Hello. Super Cabinus is with you. We send you greetings from Russia and wish you good health. Especially for our friends from America from the forum formiculture.com. We made a video with voice acting in English so that they would not be so bored of being in quarantine. We are also in quarantine. Our ants are quarantined. Yes, the whole world is in quarantine. During quarantine everyone gets bored, and we are trying to bored. Therefore, we decided to see how persistent our ants of the species Mesostructor are in achieving their goals. To do this, we decided to hang a piece of meat on a thread and see what they will do. Will they be able to cut the thread to get to it? And, yes, I forgot to say that our ants are simply delighted with chicken. When they get chicken, they just start to go crazy. After feeding the chicken, the uterus begins to carry eggs like a machine gun. Sounding of the video is carried out using Google Translator and a special program for voicing printed text. This is our first experiment in dubbing the video in this way, so if we got nonsense, don't judge us too harshly. We just wanted to entertain you. I hope we succeed, so. For this experiment we decided to assemble a special device. It is very similar to a medieval gallows. But as you can see, we love our ants so we won't hang anyone except a piece of meat. We decided to make the device itself out of small wooden skewers, on which hostesses usually prick something, when guests come to them and they want to show what type. Look how I can. You will never succeed. It doesn't matter that this food is practically not edible. But the main thing is that it looks cool on a plate. We carefully cut these sticks into small pieces and with the help of a thread we begin to assemble our construction. Since everything turns out very crookedly for us, then we start adding more sticks so that this design could somehow hold on and not crush all our ants if it suddenly decides to fall. After we assembled and prepared the entire structure, we placed it in the anthill and started shooting the video. As you can see, some of our ants ran to the surface. This amount is about 1/10 of their total number in the anthill. First we shot the general background. After that, a camera was installed so that our device was in the frame. As you can see, the ants immediately began to conquer the height of the structure. At heart, we hoped that in their quest for heights there was no thought of suicide. As you can see, our hopes came true. They are only interested in food. As recent studies have shown, during quarantine, almost everyone is only interested in food. Perhaps that is why there is a shortage of toilet paper in the world. This is sad, because if there is a shortage of food it is very difficult, then a lack of toilet paper is not only difficult, but also very inconvenient. Especially if before that you tried to quench depression with food. Friends, we all need to eat less in order to have time to replenish the world's toilet paper supplies. And so about ants. We can say that almost immediately the ants realized that there was a small, thin thread between them and the food. And then they decided that she urgently needed to be bitten. In principle, ants always gnaw something. Either in order to eat, or in order to take it to the trash. And at this time, life went on as usual inside the anthill. Now on your screens you can see the process of unpacking a new ant. You can see quite well how this happens. In the process of unpacking it was dropped. Perhaps he hit his head and in this way we get another crazy ant. They are almost all a little crazy with us. Apparently they were often dropped. But we still love them. We shot these frames on our microscope. We showed this kind of footage in our other videos. But today we decided to show you something unusual. We will show it to you literally in seconds. In the meantime, you can look a little at the larvae of our ants. As you can see, it is big enough. Obviously, the ant that will be obtained from this larva will also be very large. Almost immediately after the settlement of our anthill, and this was already more than 6 months ago, our ants got small neighbors. To be honest, we don't know who it is. They live between glass and plaster. In those small crevices where ants cannot crawl. At first, we were very worried about this. We can say and are now worried. But these creatures still do not interfere with our ants. I hope that this will be the case with further. If you have any suggestions as to who this may be, then we will be happy to hear your assumptions in the comments below the video. Now, let's go back to the surface again. Our ants are still trying to get food. Obviously, they only think about this. They continue to gnaw the thread. And as we can see, they do it very well. As you can see, not one, but several ants are trying to cut the thread. Apparently they have some kind of competition. Interesting. Will they be able to cut this thread? Let's argue. Very soon we will find out how this experiment ended. Well, while you watch how they gnaw a thread, I will tell you about what we will show in our next video. I think many of you remember the video about how we made Formicaria for our Tetramarium caespidum. To date, the number of individuals has increased, and we decided it was time to show them. During the breeding of the colony, one unpleasant event occurred, due to which we almost lost the colony, but we were able to restore the numbers. So back to our experiment. Now you can just watch the ants. There are very few left until the end of the experiment, but we just want to show you beautiful shots. Hope you enjoy it. After a couple of seconds, you will notice that we have accelerated video playback. It is now very well noticeable that the structure began to twitch, and I can assure you that we have nothing to do with it. We deliberately slowed down the length of the video so that we could better see exactly who did this. Look carefully, right now we will have the very moment we are talking about. It is simply amazing how powerful these little men are. They are really very persistent. I think we can all learn a lot from them. Well, now it's time to really be surprised. After all, one ant was trying to lift this whole construction. And not the biggest one in the colony. This is just amazing. They really amaze with their perseverance. Well, I think that the outcome of the experiment is already close. I wonder if they really love meat so much to pass this test and get to it, or whether they decide to quit. Very soon we will find out. We see that the most stubborn ant gnaws the thread, and everyone else waits until it ends. Maybe they are trying to tell him, "My friend, go relax, our shift has already ended." But he is persistent, and here is the meat on Earth. This is amazing. He did it. he did it. It seems that at the end of the shift they are waiting for a great snack. Ha 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 ha. We really hope that our idea has lifted your spirits. In any case, we wish everyone good health. We all will surely defeat this disease, and let's take quarantine as a chance to have a good rest before new achievements. We will be glad if you leave your feedback in the comments below the video. We will definitely read them and answer each of you. Good luck to everyone and all for now. There was a super cabinus with you. Take care of yourself.